When I was little, I wanted to be an astronaut. I wanted to build rockets and explore the solar system. My father used to bring me rolls of paper, these huge rolls of paper, and I would draw these detailed plans for rockets that I would then later, you know, take into space. During the day, clouds block out harmful ultraviolet radiation from the sun, but at night, they block out information from the distant universe. And for this reason, we want to send our telescopes above the clouds. We want to send them to space. That's what we specialize in at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory. We send telescopes and probes to space. And with those telescopes, we're going to make maps, enormous maps of the cosmos that are larger and more detailed than anything humanity has ever seen. And with these maps, we're going to test our theories of gravity, we're going to try to understand dark energy and discover what it is, and we're going to try to find clues about the birth and the death of our universe. Scientists don't like to admit this because it makes science seem less serious. But science can answer questions about spiritual things. I mean, astronomy is inspiring because it is spiritual. Just imagine, just think about your tiny self in this huge, enormous cosmos. I mean, that's not a scientific question, but it's something that I get to do on a daily basis. It makes me think about why the universe began and how it began. And in these questions, science and metaphysics and spirituality are mixing together. And science is able to probe all of these different realms. And we've been successful in probing these different questions to different degrees. And we're pushing them further and further as science moves along.